All right, now to Tropical Storm Erica. Here in the island chain, about 200 miles to the east of the island chain, is Tropical Storm Erica, still disorganized. The hurricane hunters flew through it this afternoon, and they really found winds of around 40 to 45 miles per hour, but even some places around 35 miles per hour, so it may actually be weakening somewhat. It's going to go through quite a bit of wind shear over the next several days, kind of what Danny did, remember, a few days ago as it made its way towards San Juan, Puerto Rico. So only 45 mile per hour winds right now, and expected Thursday and Friday. And I'll show you where the watches and warnings, the tropical storm watches and warnings, are in just a second. And then as we get into the weekend, into the southeastern Bahamas, it's still only 45 mile per hour winds. And then this is where the wind shear is going to slacken off quite a bit as we get into closer to the United States. And this is where it could increase to 65 mile per hour winds on Sunday, and then Monday afternoon, just off Cape Canaveral, as a Category 1 hurricane. But this right here is a big question mark, because it depends on how much wind shear is going to tear this thing apart, and also some dry air is just to its west, which might move into the system and wrap around into the system, which could weaken it quite a bit. So will it be like a Danny and just fall apart, and then this would be just the remnants moving here, which would be kind of nice, because we certainly don't want a hurricane getting close to Florida. But all the computer models are really starting to change. They're very consistent, as you can see, tightly packed over the next 2 or 3 days. And then what happens? We have one that actually goes right between the Outer Banks and Bermuda. This is at Monday of next week, and then we have one that goes through Cuba. So look at the difference. Quite the spread. Could actually move into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico. But watching the computer models over the last 2 or 3 days, the track continues to go a little bit farther right each time. So we're taking the southeastern Gulf of Mexico out of the picture and starting to move it. I really think this is what's going to happen. Even a couple of days, that there's going to be a trough that's going to dig across our area in the upper atmosphere. It may pick up this system and hopefully keep it offshore from the Carolina and Georgia coast, and Florida for that matter, but it's probably going to move through the Bahamas. Whether or not it's a tropical storm or the remains or a hurricane, still not sure yet, because the computer models are all over the place as far as intensity in this time period. But I think it's going to probably start to curve away and move right through. Probably this model. Let's hope so. But we still got plenty of time to watch it, and I'll certainly keep you updated. But right now, the watches and warnings, tropical watches and tropical warnings, now for the northern island part of the Leeward Islands, the northern part, also San Juan, Puerto Rico, but now the northeastern part of the Dominican Republic, and now for the first time there, and in the southeastern Bahama Islands, a tropical storm watch has been posted. So we'll watch Erica and see if she can get through all this wind shear over the next several days, and then start to re-intensify in day 4 and 5 down the road.